Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode. But in this class I will not be discussing the editorial of the day. The reason is it deals with identity politics, and I have already done n number of editorials on identity politics. Now if you want to read on identity politics, you can search one of my editorials on identity politics. That will give you an idea about how identity politics works in India and how this identity politics has crystallized and how efforts needs to be made in order to melt this identity politics. So let us talk for the day what we are going to do today. Today I will be dealing with the triple talaq issue. Now this is a very important issue. This issue relates to social issues. So social issues are part of general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 3. Now what is meant by triple talaq? First of all, we will be dealing with that. Secondly, we will be dealing with how customary laws and the constitutional provisions, they are not in consonance, how they are not in sync with each other. And then we will also be dealing with how this triple talaq issue is different from uniform civil code. Now first of all, let us understand the constitutional provisions. Now constitution treats man and woman equal. We have right to equality under Article 14. Article 14 is the most sacrosanct article of the Indian Constitution. Now this article exhibits how man and woman, they should be treated with parity in all the domains, be it social, be it economic, be it political. But as far as the social domain is concerned, this domain is also occupied by the personal laws. What are these personal laws? Personal laws like laws relating to marriage, laws relating to adoption, laws relating to inheritance. So these are the three things in which these personal laws work. Now, where do these personal laws come from? This is a very important question. Now, most of the personal laws that we have, they actually come from the customs that the mankind has been practicing, that the humans have been practicing. Now, because they come from the customs, what we know is that there are different and distinct and disparate type of customs operating in the world. And similarly, we also have different customs operating in India. Now, most of the customs that work, they are actually based on religion. So we have Hindu-based customary law, we have Muslim-based customary law, and then we have Christian-based customary law. And the religions like Jainism, Buddhism, Sikhism, they all practice this thing, Hindu customary laws. So most of the customary laws that we have their root in religion. This is the most important thing to understand. Now when it comes to the Constitution of India, it offers equal space to man and woman. But when it comes to religion, religion is not in sync with modern times. All the religions in that sense, be it Hindus, be it Muslims, be it Christians. Now when it comes to the Hindu religion, it is the reformists who had fought valiant war against the depredations, against the evils that were afflicting the personal laws of the Hindu religion. Like the reformists, they have fought against child marriage. Reformists, they have fought against sati system. Reformists, they have fought for widow remarriage. So it is not only about the Muslim religion, it is also about the Hindu religion, how Hindu religion has reformed. Now when it comes to the Muslim religion, we have one evil afflicting this religion. And what is this evil? The evil is the triple talaq. In the triple talaq, we make it very easy for the man to divorce his wife. And the logic for most of the divorces that are done through this route of triple talaq, they are actually just based on man's whims and fancies. They are just based on the mood swings of man. They are just based on irrational and illogical reasons. So such kind of practice, it thwarts the womanization of a man. Now what is womanization of a man? Womanization of a woman. Now what it means? It means that the woman is not able to assert herself. It thwarts that practice. Woman is not able to assert her right. Woman has no equality. So this is something that has already been decided by Supreme Court in numerous cases of how triple talaq is against the practice of equality, how this triple talaq is also against how it has been mentioned in the Qurans. Now when it comes to the readings of Quran, Quran has highlighted how this triple talaq should be practiced in a period of 90 days and how there should be a process of mediation in these 90 days. 90 dinon mein aap isko talaq ko kara sakte ho, triple talaq ko. Agar aapne isko execute karana hai, if you want to execute it properly, in that case, there should be 90 days through which this triple talaq exercise should be carried out. And in these 90 days, there should be a mediation process. Now, what is a mediation process? Mediation process means there should be a kind of a dialogue. There should be a kind of a reconciliation process between the errant husband and wife. Jo husband and wife aapas mein lad rahe hain, jo aapas mein divorce karna chahte hain, unka aapas mein baat karana chahiye. So there should be some kind of talks going on between man and woman. Taki ho sakta hai reconcile ho jaye. So this is known as mediation. And this mediation thing must take place. Now when it comes to the marriage, when the marriage is consummated, the permission is not only taken from man, but it is also taken from woman in the form of kabool hai, kabool hai. But it, when it comes to the divorce, it is only the man who dictates. Who dictates this thing, who dictates the divorce. The order and the dictates cannot come from women. So this thing goes against the constitutional provision of Indian constitution. But we have another side of this, to this triple talaq issue. The issue of, in Islam and as per Quran, more responsibility has been conferred to the man in order to carry out this institution of marriage. Carry out this institution of marriage means maintaining marriage, providing support to women, providing support to the children. So the more responsibility is put on the shoulders of a man, and because of this reason, man also have the authority, man also have the more privilege, man also have the more freedom to break the marriage that is not working. So there are different interpretations. Supreme Court has already passed verdict in this case. Again, this case is pending with the Supreme Court. Now let us wait how the Supreme Court decides about. Now basically, when it comes to these personal laws, all these personal laws should be in sync with the modern values, modern liberal values. Though religion is very important, though customs of the people are also important, but these customs should not be hitting at the rights of the women section. This is the most important thing. So this is all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to view the information of the classes, visit BrainyIAS.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.